and welcome to the Race to Play DBF's Truck Series race here at Texas. I'm Daniel Blanco alongside cameraman Sydney Thomas. Reporter David Nannan was supposed to be here tonight, but he had some unexpected family coming over, so he will not be able to make it. So it's just me and Sydney tonight. We are live right now in warm-up at Texas. Anthony Dineen on the pole. Got a big field here tonight. About 17 racers here at Texas. Going to be a pretty cool race. No caution. Caution-free races.
Looks like we've got a few cars on the track for warm-up here before we go for this 80 lap. No cautions. Rules here is no passing before turn one on the start. So you'll see cars go clean into turn one. No pileups or wrecks. Texas here, you can pretty much run flat-footed all the way around the track. Interested to see what the tire wear situation is going to be here.
Oh yeah, and also Anthony Dineen, since I've been in this server, has been fastest by quite a lot, big margin actually. So interesting. I've never seen him in a race before. He's Canadian, so that's good. Always good. And he's kind of new, so this is like I think about his second or third race. And it's gonna be interesting to see how he does. He had two accounts, one he never raced on, and this one's previously updated. So. Cool, I like his name, pretty cool.
Yeah, looks like we have a few new guys in here as well.
Oh yeah, we have Chris Hogue. This is his first race on Race to Play. And it's a truck series at Texas, pretty good way to start out. We also have James Cassidy, also new. I have no info on him, so please don't ask. And Kieran Swart, which is a road course racer. He mostly races touring cars at Race to Play, not real life. So yeah, some new faces definitely this season.
Yeah, we have some old ones as well. Looks like Tom Mosley is going to race with the guys tonight, bringing him out of retirement.
Yep. And here we go. Race is about to begin.
Okay, we have the cars lining up on pit road. And the pace car should be taking them out here in just a second.
Alright, so if I may, I will now present you with the starting lineup today at Texas. So, the front row is shared by newbie, Anthony Dineen. Gets the pole with a blazing lap. He beat Tom Mosley by about 2/10 almost in qualifying. Tom Mosley qualifies second, a very good truck racer and very good DHR racer and team owner at Race Play. Second row. In third place is Luis Almeida, and fourth place is Romar Arns. Well known, very good qualifier. In fifth is Ron Coles. And just alongside him is 6th place Marcio Cayetano, who appears to have spun out on the pace lap. Oh, and he got hit, too. That's not good, actually.
It's not pretty good. Before you take the green flag, you accumulate damage.
Oh, that's not good. Anyway, 7th and 8th go to Jim Berisoff of DBF, alongside teammate Eric Harlan. The top 10 are rounded out by Giovanni Machado, another road course racer, and James Cassidy. 11th and 12th are taken by Aaron Bianduga Sr. and Ellery Souza. Chris Hogue making his Truck Series and Race to Play Series debut, 13th, alongside Jacob Mowry. Here we go, we're coming to the green. We are green here at Texas. Oh, a couple of people got loose in the back here. It appears Anthony Dineen wanted to start in the back. He is already at the back with Marcio, which means Luis Almeida is currently on the point, ahead of teammate Romar Arns. Good to see Ron Coles out there. Ron Coles runs very well here in the Truck Series. Canadian, by the way. Our Canadians are always good. And we have another Canadian in fourth, Jim Barasov.
Yeah, it looks like Luis has got about a 2-3 car truck length lead over Romar.
Yep. Eric Harlan is in fifth. So we have three DBFs, third, fourth, and fifth. Be dominating right there. Machado is already up to sixth, the road courser. Don't usually see him that high, so he has a very good start right now. Then James Cassidy, the newbie. Chris Hogue is in ninth. Very smooth line. I see him having a very smooth line. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it looks like the first couple of laps there, Tom Mosley ran the fastest lap.
Wow, Tom Mosley. He's way back in the pack, too. I guess he just wanted to start back there and stay out of trouble. Whoa. Car loose in front of him. Oh, we had a wreck in the back. Chris Hogue got tapped. And, oh, Jesus. Oh.
Yeah, it looks like there's still wrecking
more
back there.
A lot more involved. Marcio Cayetano, the one who wrecked on the pace lap. Chris Hogue. Aaron Bianduga Sr. also got back. Anthony Dineen, the pollster, the fastest car here in every session. Scott Stenger is also slow. I believe he's the one that got into him. And Jacob Mowry has heavy damage on the right side. Along with Kayron Swart, another newbie.
Yeah, remember, in this series here, there's no caution, so it's still green flag. And these guys got to get themselves out of the way and get down to pit road and fix that damage.
Alright, so I'll go check the replay and see what happened here. As we already have one casualty, Marcio Cayetano is out of the race. So I think and believe here with Chris Hogue making his first ever race play start. Pretty tough way to start it in the truck series because there are no cautions. Now it looks like Chris Hogue in the trial just got too high, hit the wall, came down on Jacob Mowry and spun through the infield. Almost saved it. He came back up, tapped the wall, and then stood back down in front of Aaron and Marcio.
Yeah, it's a tough break for Jacob. He runs under my team banner, iPro Race stock car. And, you know, he's trying to get a good finish here. Last few races, he didn't get the finish that he wanted, and he's trying to move up in the points. So, real tough break for Jacob.
Yeah, that sucks. He's still out there, though. Still hanging in there. He has some heavy right front damage.
Okay. Looks like we still got the top four guys still running out front. Leaving about one car length between each other.
Yep. Almeida went back to third, and Barasov is in fourth. So we have two Canadians in the top four.
And you got Eric Harlan back there. Just kind of watching out. He's about a half straightaway away from him, but he's slowly inching his way up.
Ellery Souza, wow, he's up to sixth already. A bit of a slow start, he's sneaking up there. Oh, Machado all the way to the bottom, trying to... I'm not sure if he's letting him by or blocking Mosley there. He might have been letting by. He's not usually a blocker. Thought someone
looks like
someone
got
a loose back there, Cassidy.
There.
Yeah. Also, another one, Matt Crash. You might think, because of his last name, he crashes a lot. Well, he has 127 races at Race to Play and only 17 DNFs. So, very consistent racer. He races a lot in the open wheel and touring car series. So, I like him. He's a pretty funny guy.
Let's see if we can take a ride on board here with Matt and just watch some of the action from inside the car.
Alright. Some cars exiting pit road. That car was Chris Hoag getting some damage repaired. He had some very light front end damage with some pretty extensive rear damage. Solid. And the rear ends on these cars are very, very sensitive. Trust me, I know. I've wrecked things a lot.
Yeah, we're looking like we're about 11 laps in, and hated for the guys in the back who got tangled up in that start. But let's see how it shakes out for him towards the end.
I feel bad, especially for Aaron Bianduca Sr. This guy usually gets caught up in something that is not really his fault, and that happened there with a car swooping down and catching him. That really sucks. He's a really nice guy. Great, clean racer. Never gets into any of the dirty situations, and it kind of sucks for him to be out so early. But he always tries his best to finish. So hopefully he'll probably finish here. Chris Hoag is just ahead of him in position.
Yeah, it looks like we have a change for position in the lead. Romar passed Luis, so Romar now.
Oh, a car in the wall in the back straightaway. Seems to be James Cassidy. Hit the wall pretty hard and has some pretty heavy right front damage. Sorry about that, Sydney. Just saw that in the back.
Yeah, it looks like he's going to limp around and head to pit road here, get that car.
Oh, he spun on the first straightaway here. He spun. Jesus. He kicked it up near the wall. That's a lot of damage. He hit that thing hard. Always a suspension damage from when he hit the wall earlier. Now, the leaders are coming back around. He's just going to sit there. Oh, my. Hope no one hits him here. Oh, my God.
Yeah, looks like he needs to get off the track there or get it going.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Oh! Oh, Jesus, he just got hit by K-Ron Swartz. Oh, my God. Saw that coming. Oh, Machado has just officially DNF, and there goes Cassidy now. He escaped. That sucks. There's two more cars now, probably. Yep, K-Ron Swartz is now out. His car was done after he hit him. Wow, that sucks. I don't know what he was trying to do there. James Cassidy is also out now. That's a bummer, especially for K-Ron. That's a bummer. I'm trying to look and see what happened to James here.
Yeah, while you do that, let's take a moment and go through the field. You have Roman Arns in first, Ron Cole in second. You have Jim Berasoff in third. Luis in fourth. And Eric Harlan rounding out top five.
Yep. I'll give another one a spin on the front straightaway again. It's Anthony Dineen. Wow, so scratch what I said in the pre-race. He's not having the best race today. So he was really fast, man. He put some really fast laps down. He was very consistent, but I guess starting at the back, for whatever reason he did, was not working out for him. Aaron Bianduca Sr. has also just officially out of the race. Romar still out in front over Ron Coles. He has about a 1.5 second lead. And then Jim Berasoff, so a pair of Canadians on the podium so far.
Yeah, it looks like there's a lot of cars out. Going back here, looks to 15th and 16th place. They're still in the race. But cars 12 through 14. And we have a spinner here going down to pit road.
Oh, it's Hoag. Oh, he's going to hit the wall again. Oh, man. He's had a rough race, and he's out. He just escaped, so a rough debut here. That sucks. That's a bummer.
Yeah, I don't think a lot of these guys put the time on the track, and you know, got a feel for the truck to see what the truck's going to do on a long run. May have practiced a bunch of short runs, so looks like they're not getting a good handle on their car.
Yeah, they're tough, man. So six drivers already out, and before he loses his internet, I'm going to give a shout-out to my really good friend, Nathan Block. He's an up-and-coming open-wheel racer, races here in Canada. So I watched him race one time, two times actually, one time in Montreal, and one time where he almost got the win at a local airport racetrack. So he won the championship last season in the Formula 1600s. He's watching today, so just a shout-out to him, a great buddy of mine, an awesome kid. You guys also might have seen him on Dragon's Den. He went on there to try to get sponsorship, and he did. And got funding for the rest of the season, so... He clearly doesn't have a full ride, so if any scouts out there watching, pick this kid up, or I'm going to hurt you. Because he's a great kid, a great driver, too. Awesome guy. He's watching today, so... Pretty cool. Some high-profile people here.
Yeah, it looks like Romar's pulling away with the 2 second lead.
Oh, yeah, so, 2.2 second lead over Ron. And Jim is catching him. Oh, would you believe this? Tom Mosley, last time I saw him about 10 laps ago, he was back there in ninth. He's now in fourth position. And he's climbing. I believe he has the fastest lap in the race so far. No, that goes to Ron Coles, actually. He just beat him. It's good to see Ron doing it, though. But man, Tom is on the move. That's typical from him.
Yeah, Tom's one of those guys. He'll lay back and, you know, just let his car do its thing. But then towards the end, you'll see that truck right up front giving some good battle for the lead. Tom's the champion here. He's won at Texas quite a few times, so he knows how to get around this track.
I used to race with these guys week in and week out, and then just started losing interest in iRacing now, so... I know Tom, he's a very patient driver. That's one of the best things about him, very patient driver. And he usually stays out of all the wrecks pretty early, and he did that today, and now he's all the way up to fourth. Pretty cool to see him drive up the field.
Yeah, let's take a lap here on board with Tom and just see what it's like to get around this Texas track.
You guys are probably on board right now with, I would say, a 4-plus time champion here. In all the series, so he knows his way around all these tracks, and he knows VHR at the back of his hand. So he pretty much keeps it alive. He runs DBF. He organizes all the stock car races. He gets everyone to come in. Very demoted to his team and to this series. And he is fast. Very nice.
Yeah, looks like we got a battle up here with second and third.
Yep.
You have Ron close. And Jim. Jim's not going to push it too hard. He's just going to wait for that opportunity. And once Ron makes a mistake.
Oh, we have a spinner in turn three and four. It's Ellery Souza. And that was a driver who was just up in the top six. And look who's about to pass him, Jacob Mowry, who are still out there riding around with that damage. He's up to 8th now, but sucks for Ellery Souza.
Yeah, it looks like he's going to take it down pit road and get some repair damage done to that truck. Yeah, it's a tough break.
I'm not sure what happened there. I'm going to go check on the replay. Oh, it seems like he was just going to pit anyway. And he just lost it on the apron, just got loose on him and spun out. He almost came back up on the racetrack, so that was lucky. He didn't get caught by anybody. He's back on track now, so. Whoa.
And here comes the leaders coming by him there.
Oh yeah, he's really loose down there. I wonder if something's wrong with the suspension or something. He's really loose. Oh, and Tom now has caught Jim Barisoff and Ron Cole, so now it's a three-way race for second, as Romar Arns has pulled away to a 4.3-second lead. Massive.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Romar likes that these guys are battling it out for the second spot. allows him to run his line and just set the pace.
I mean, but he also has to be worrying some too, because remember, they're drafting, so they could gain on him. So
yeah, they could. I know two of them. Actually, all three of those guys.
Yeah,
are
they're
teammates,
all teammates.
So.
Yep, they're all DBF. Forgot about that.
Yes, I don't think they're going to make
they're not
too many drastic
moves. They keep on running like that. 29.9 the last lap for Romar Arns. A 30.2 the last lap for Ron Coles. So, wow. In fact,
yeah.
Second, third, and fourth right now all belong to DBF. Two teams in the whole top five. Team, I believe it's owned by Romar Arns. He is their main driver. He has a teammate in fifth, so just two teams are covering the entire top five. And in sixth place is yet another DBF driver. Oh, I just went on Jacob Mower's view, and it looks like he wanted a pit, but he broke a little bit too late. Didn't work, so. Still out there with that damage. Don't cred, man. It's hard to hang on to these things with damage.
Yeah, it looks like you got Matt crashed behind Eric Harlan there. He's suddenly
catch up to them, and Luis Almeida is falling back, surprisingly enough. And Ron and Tom Mosley has just passed both Canadians and pushed them back like he usually does. He's now up to second. Wow, what a drive for him. He is driving up through this field. He has an amazing truck. Oh, and Anthony Dineen has just DNF'd, and he's now out. So now there are only 10 cars remaining, so no matter what you do, you're going to get a stat. Top 10. Minimum. And that belongs right now to Ellery Souza, so.
Yeah, that's not good for these guys that were in the back. You know, you had 17 cars, trucks out there, and now you're down to top 10, and, you know, we're just a little over halfway, so. Now you should start seeing the real good drivers out there. They're going to put their laps down, and they're going to try to bring these trucks home and give themselves a good finish.
Yep. So Romar's last lap, 29.991. Tom's last lap, a 30.149. So he's not that far off. Can we see him run him down? They're about as straight away between each other. Wow, a 6-second lead for Romar. And he's fast. He's usually really fast by himself. And he's very, very quick in qualifying. He's known for that. It's just the cautions that usually he just doesn't pit very well. So now it's good to see him, you know, out there. And it makes sense because these races don't have any cautions. So when he's fast and consistent like that and he has those kind of setups, it makes it hard for the competition.
Yeah, but as long as he doesn't get up on some of these lap traffic and, you know, somebody makes a mistake spin or gets loose and runs into him, if he keeps the damage away, I think he's going to pull off a solid, strong win here.
Oh, yeah. You never know with Tom. He's always lurking back there. I've been leading, and Tom has been behind me, and, man, you just don't know. Like, he could get you on pit strategy, or he could get you just based on speed, or when he pits, or tires. Pretty mysterious guy. Kind of annoying, but he's cool.
Yeah, so why don't you go ahead and take us through the field, starting up front with Romar.
Yeah, Romar out in front with a 6.7-second lead over Tom Mosley. And the podium belongs to them, plus Canadian Ron Coles in the battle for second, third, and fourth is kind of calmed down and spread out. Canadian Jim Berezov is in fourth. Eric Harlan, another DBF driver, is in fifth. So that means DBF is now second, third, fourth, and fifth. So all four of their cars are up there. Wow, that's amazing. Luis Almeida has fallen back to sixth. He had a strong car at the beginning, but seems to be wearing down now. Matt Crash looking to make a move on him in seventh. Remember, he's a very good road course racer. Pretty cool to see him doing good up here. Only two career wins in 127 races.
Yeah, Matt's right up there on the back bumper. He's running that low line. He's hoping to get down on him and get a good run coming off the turn.
And Luis just mentioned that he will be pitting this time, so it looks like him and maybe Matt Crash also might, or maybe not. Nope, just Luis. Oh, And he's going to spin out, and he just avoided the wall. He just spun out in turn 3 and 4, just like Ellery Souza did. So, just like Ellery, he spins out trying to pit.
Yeah, it looks like they're trying to cut it close coming into the pit road. And just got down on that apron, got a little loose.
Oh, leader's pitting, Romo like pitting. Sorry to cut you off there, but the leader is pitting. Giving up that huge, huge lead. Oh, so is Tom Mosley now. Tom Mosley is also pitting. So we have three cars on pit road. Luis Almeida, Romar Arns, and Tom Mosley all on pit road. There's another one down there.
That gives the lead to Ron Coles.
Yep.
With Matt Crash moving up to second.
Wow. Eric Harlan is also on pit road. So that's two DBFs on pit road. And here comes Jim Berisoff. I believe that's Jacob Mowry. On pit road, going to finally get that damage fixed. Good for him. He hung out there for a long time with that damage. Credit to him, man. This track is very hard. Oh, no, so we got a spinner in turn four again. Another one spinning out trying to come to pit road. He's going to, like, stop right there. Where's the end of the pits? Who is that? Oh, it's Matt Crash, who's got the lead. That sucks. He's having a good race. Shouldn't lose that much time, but anything's very important for him. So. Also, Ron Cole is now in the pits. Romar Arns gets back into the lead. Ron is in the pits. So, no surprise, strategy here by Tom Mosley, so I guess he's just going to try to catch him the old-fashioned way, just run him down.
Yeah, it looks like the pits are cycling around. Tom's back in second, Romar's in the lead.
We have somebody re-pitting here, I believe. Oh, no, never mind, it's Scott Stenger. Scott Stenger's in the pits. He has some slight right side damage and slight right front damage. Probably from the earlier incident on lap 1 or 2. Scott Stenger, I like to call him just Mr. Consistent. He's just really clean and really consistent. He's never really up towards the front, but at the end of the race, he's always up there. Just running a good race, and he gets good points for that. He stays out of trouble, so I like that. Cool. Jacob Mowry has finally had that damage fixed. That's good. Good for him. Matt crashes in 7th. And to tell you the rest of the top 10, I was not able to finish it off before. Actually, I'll wait till the pit stops are over. Tom Mosley. Right now, I see Tom Mosley is 11.5 seconds behind. I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure he had to fix some damage. That's probably why he lost that ground. If it's not, maybe Romar took 2, but I doubt that he would take 2. So there's probably damage being fixed on Tom's part.
Yeah, I'm showing you 11.3 seconds behind for Tom.
Yeah. Ellery Souza right now is in 3rd. Pretty sure. Did he pit? I don't know if he pitted or not.
Yeah, with those fresh tires, looks like Romar just set the fastest lap.
Oh, Luis. Ellery has not pit yet. So, we have Scott Stenger back in the pits. Not sure if maybe he had a pass there or something. Oh, no. He's had a long pit stop. Never mind. He did not go back in the pits. He was already in there, I guess, to fix. I guess he had more damage than I see right here.
Yeah, we got Scott here with this unsponsored red truck.
Yeah. Well, that's the Ford custom skin, so I guess he has his own skin in there. Had to update all that. Jacob Mowry in 9th. Jim Berisoff is in 8th, so. Not sure what happened there. Maybe he had some damage and I had to fix it. that was him, I probably wouldn't know, because it cost him a lot of spots. But he's not that far behind at Crash. So. Sixth place goes to Ron Coles, falling back a little bit. Luis Almeida, whose truck seems to be a lot better on the shorter run, he's up in fifth. Everett Carlin's in fourth. Souza, who hasn't pitted yet, is in third. Palmozzi is second, and Romar Arns with the 11-second lead out in first. He has had the clean race today. Cleanest race of all of them right now.
Yeah, the pit stops here, looks like we're looking at 30 laps to go.
Yep, one lap away from 30 to go, I believe, yeah. No, we're actually on 30 laps to go right now.
And it looks like Tom's chopping into that lead of Romar. Tom's back now by 10.9. Last time it was 11.3.
All right. I'm trying to chip in, but he's gonna have to chip off a bit more than that. He's in that short amount of time, he's gained three. He's gonna have to gain three about every lap if he's gonna try to catch him. But he could do it. I mean, you always have a lot of pressure when you're in first, no matter how big your lead it is. When you know that Tom Mosley is in second, you really wanna put on a good show because he's one of the best drivers out here. He's always out there contending for the win and the championship, so.
You know, because this is sim racing and we rely on our internet connection for racing, remember, you know, there's been a couple of times where Romar has had some internet problems and ruined the race for him, so it's not over yet.
Yeah, it's never over till it's over. And that can't be said enough when you're racing online. Internet connections can be a pain a lot.
And also, I've seen watch out races, for these guys.
No, Scott Stender just wrecked in front of Tom Mosley, and Tom Mosley's spinning out in turn one. Oh, Jesus. Oh, no, and he caught Jim Berisoff as well. Oh, that is the worst way, man.
Yeah, it's Jim like Berisoff, it's out. Never over till it's over, you know, and when you got these lap down cars, you have to really be careful around.
Tom is out of the race. So now that's two more. That sucks. A lot. Scott Stender. Wow. I'm pretty sure he did exactly like what Anthony Dineen did before, earlier in the race. He bounced off the wall, trying to let Tom go by, give him some space. And he just bounced down and hit him. And unfortunately, that caught Jim Berisoff as well. So back-to-back bad races for Jim. And can you believe it, man? Tom Mosley, after the great race he was having and running down a leader, gets wrecked by a lap car. That's a bummer. And he slid right back up and got... Oh, God, Jim, that sucks. Scott Stender is also officially out now, too, so... That's what's LB Souza in second right now. And that's a 27-second lead. 27 seconds. In fact, they're on the same straightaway right now. So he pretty much has a lap on the field. So pushing aside any problems with the connection or any lap cars getting in Romar's way, he's got this right now. But since we just saw it three times already this race, this could happen again. But with this many fewer cars on track... Now down to, I believe, seven.
Yeah, DBF was looking pretty good early on in this run, but now the bad luck's starting to strike, and there's a couple more cars still out there for the DBF team, so it's not over yet. We still could have some more action here, and that lead that Romar's got, it's just really impressive, but you never know when you get around some of these lap cars.
Yeah, Romar, never mind, is that Romar? Yeah, Romar trying to get around Eric Harlan, another DBF driver. Eric won't give him any much trouble at all. Oh, he's still racing him on it, so maybe he might.
Yeah, I think that Eric's what? He's still on the lead lap, right? So he may be racing for on that lead lap.
Yeah, he's on the lead lap. Yeah. Not a really big point in that though. I mean, it's no caution to get your lucky dog, get your lap back. So. Well, I mean, sure, have some fun. I mean, there's not a lot of cars left out there. Why not race Romar? I mean, he has a big lead, but I would be careful based on what's been happening in this race.
Yeah, I'm surprised Romar has passed him, you know, with the speeds he's been setting. So that tells you that there's a good car in front of him.
And trust me, when you're leading, you hate it when a lap car decides to race you because it's just frustrating. You just want to get by every lap car. Every lap car is an obstacle to you. So with a lap car in front of him, I'm not sure Romar's mentality coming into this race or with lap cars, but I'm not sure if he's going to get frustrated or not. But it looks like right now, actually, Eric seems to be driving away from him, so might not be his fault.
Yeah, I wonder if he went in and got some fresh tires and that's what's showing here.
Yeah, possibly. I think he did pit a lap later, so that could be the difference. Who knows? In fact, second and third right now, you can just watch on board with Romar because you're watching the top three. There's second right ahead of Romar. Ellery Souza. Luis Almeida, would you believe it or not, is actually behind the leader. He's in fourth. A lap down, so. Pretty good comeback by him. Ron, still in the top five. He is fifth. Surprisingly enough, he's having a good clean race. Usually he's the one that gets caught up in someone else's mess. I mean, I've seen it every single week. It seems like this guy gets caught up in something that's just not his fault and just sucks. I mean, it's either something on pit road, someone spins out and hits him, or just simply a wreck on the back straightaway and someone will just have to pop up and hit him. You know? I mean, even one time, I heard he was leading with two laps to go in a race and someone lagged and popped up right in front of him and he lost it, so. At least he's going to finish this one in the top five as of right now, so that's good.
Yeah, it's another DBF driver there, Ron Coles.
Yep. DBF is third and fifth at the moment.
Matt crashed in there. Sixth place. Jacob Mowry moved up to seventh.
Yeah, Jacob Mowry still hanging in there. Involved in the crash on lap two and three. Man, wow. He's still in there. Well, great job by him.
Yeah, let's take a ride on board with Jacob and see the track from his view.
And I've raced here before. My first race here at Texas, it was in the Truck Series, just like the other guy, Chris Hogue. And I got into an accident early in the race, and just like Jacob, I had heavy damage that affected my toe, and I just couldn't hang on to it. It was just so loose and. It'll loose and then it'll go to the other side, just be really tight. So, creds to him. I didn't even finish that race and it looks like Jacob will, so. Pretty cool. It's hard to win these races, man. These races are long, as you can see. These races wear you down. Your body hurts. I mean, it might just be sitting down in your computer driving, but you just get tired after a while. Your muscles are hurting.
I'm surprised, though, that, there's only eight drivers remaining on the track. It's just really surprising, you know. Seems like everybody got racy real early on, didn't get a feel for their truck, and ended up with DNFs.
Yeah, that's a bummer. Especially early wrecks like that, like a wreck on lap two and three, that's gotta save your stuff, especially in these truck series. There are no cautions. Once you wreck, your race will never be the same again. Now you're just playing catch back up to the original position and then try to gain more spots. So truck races are very tough. Yeah, and Matt Crash, like I said, he's up there in six. That's pretty cool. This guy likes to finish a lot, so I like that. Only 17 DNFs, so
that's pretty good record there.
Yep, 127 DNFs. I mean, 127 events and only 17 DNFs.
Yeah, you must be looking up my stats, 127 DNFs, huh?
127 DNFs. And I just did my math here, and that's a 7% of the time. Only 7% of the time he will DNF. So, pretty cool. It's not bad, man. He has two wins. Yeah, I think he has about 30-plus podiums, so he's there. He just doesn't really... He's just not there, you know? He's just not in contention for the win, but he's always up there, which is cool. I haven't really raced him a lot. Pretty sure he's a Skoda guy. I've seen him race the Skodas before. Those are some wild touring cars, man. Those are awesome.
So looks like down 11 laps to go.
Yep, 10 to go now.
29.5 second lead.
We have 29, almost 30 second lead. Oh, that's almost a lap. And that's over Eric Harlan. Ellery Souza pitted. So he turned his race around a lot here. Especially after that three-car pileup, which took out three people for position for Ellery. And he has Ron Cole steaming up behind him. And in fact, that's for position. That's a battle for fourth, so we should go check out that. Battle for fourth here, Ron and Ellery. And Ron's going to want it. He wants as many points as he can because two of his teammates are out. So.
Yeah, but he's got plenty of time to pass him here. 9 laps to go. I wouldn't make any moves that'll take him out of contention. He's pretty solid right now in the top 5.
Oh yeah, top 5 is... I want to be pleased, very, very pleased with the top 5 finish in the truck race. It's hard to get through these. Especially when you see Rex on the track and you can't let off. You try to get everything you get, and then there'll be a car sitting right there, and the next thing you know, you're out of the race, so... I believe it's Romar still behind Eric. No, he passed him. Look at that.
Yeah, it looks like Ron's trying to work him on the high side a little bit. Sosa sticking to the bottom as he goes into the turn.
Yeah, whoa, he got really close to his back bumper. Oh, he gave him a push. Oh, he just put him in the wall. Oh my god, he just put him right in the wall. I don't know what's...
And there's Ron spinning out as well.
Oh no, what happened there? Why? Why did he do that? He's not the type of person.
7 laps to go, wow.
7 laps to go, and he put him in a wall, and now he just spun out. And his car is heavily damaged. He could barely get it to go now. But he has heavy, heavy right side and rear end damage. And Ellery Souza now is out there laughing. Now he's out there in 4th position, no one around him. Next closest person is Matt Crash behind him, but he has extensive right side damage.
Wow, yeah, like I was saying, odd. You know, a few laps to go, you know, he had plenty of time to work him, and I guess got a little bit impatient there, and that was the result.
I'm not sure if they had a feud already going, but it just seemed like he just never let off. I was riding on board of him. He just never seemed to let off. I don't know what happened there.
I wonder if Ron got
the worst of it.
I wonder if Ellery checked up a little bit. Like I said early on broadcast, you can pretty much flat foot around this track. So I wonder if he let off a little bit and Ron was still flat foot, and that's where he got him turned around.
Possibly, yeah. I'm going to go watch the replay and watch it from both engine views and see if Ellery's engine cracked at all.
Yeah, and that moves Matt Crash up to top 5.
Yeah, 5th position, and laps are winding down here. 4 to go. Some are still with that huge lead. Alright, so I'm going to try to see here.
As we ride back on board with the leader.
Well, Ron did let off. It seemed like he just got loose heading into the corner. Ellery did. He just got loose heading in, and Ron just could not just keep off of him. He just couldn't keep off of him. He was slowing down too much, and that just made him put him in the wall. And then after that, I guess he just checked up a little bit because he just kind of was, whoa, what just happened, you know? And then he spun out, which sucks for both of them. They were both having good races.
Yeah, it looks like he, you know, was going with the momentum. And
they're back on track, right near each other right now, so let's see what they do. There's Ron right again, right behind Ellery, and sometimes he can have a bit of a short temper, so... Trust me, I know, he's gonna let him go. So far. Okay.
Yeah, I think Ron's just looking to finish the race now, you know, with 2 laps to go, winding down.
They are on TeamSpeak, so... Maybe Ron said, oh shit, sorry, you know, didn't mean to do that. Now he's in 7th, so he lost his step.
Okay, 1 lap to go, Romar Arns.
Yep, dominating one lap, the last lap the right now, here he comes to the checkered. By an entire lap, Romar Arns will take the win here at Texas. Wow, huge win for him, that is massive. I have never seen that before. And Eric Harlan finishes a strong 2nd for DBF. What a race by Romar. Luis Almeida will get 3rd. Matt Crash drives his way all the way up, keeps clean, finishes 4th place. Ellery manages to limp home in 5th. Jacob Mowry, another one, just last, just good with all that damage. Great day for him. 6th place. And Ron Bowles, 7th place. The last car winning on the track. To round out your top 10 is Tom Mosley, Jim Barasoff, and Scott Stenger. The rest of your field, Anthony Dineen, Kayron Swart, Giovanni Machado, James Cassaday, in 15th making his debut at race to play, Chris Hogue, and then in the final two, Aaron Bianduga Sr. and Marcio Caetano round out your field.
Yeah, there's Romar doing his burnouts here by the start-finish line.
Yep.
Looks like he may have stalled his truck out. There he goes. He's got it going.
I've seen some good wins by Romar, but that's pretty impressive. That's an entire lap, so that's a perfect race on a scratch on that car. Congrats to Romar. So I hope you guys enjoyed that one. That was a pretty intense race, man. A lot of wrecks, a lot of... unfortunate races, not unfortunate endings for a lot of people, like Jim Barasoff, especially Tom Mosley trying to catch Romar. Sucks for Ellery Souza and Ron, who got into it very late. Seems like Ron just can't go one race without having something happening like that, but it's racing.
Yeah, that is. Let's see if we can get Romar and... maybe Tom or some of the other guys up here in the booth and talk about their race.
All right, let's see.
Thank you all for coming out and watching the DBF Motorsports truck race at Texas on iProRace TV.
A lot of work goes into this, a lot of camera work here by Sydney Thomas, our wonderful cameraman, beautiful individual. And we have another race on Thursday. It's the Nationwide Series at Texas. It will be broadcasted by yours truly here and Sydney Thomas, so come back if you want. Again, another shout out to my buddy Nathan Block, a great open wheel driver. We'll see him in F1 in a couple of years, guarantee it. He was watching tonight, and thanks to all of you for watching, and we'll see you next race. Please feel free to add any comments on Facebook or on TeamSpeak or come tell us your thoughts about the race. It's muchly appreciated. Thank you.
Next race in the truck series is going to be at Kansas. Looks like they're going to run 80 laps. Again, with no cautions, no passing into turn one, so that should be a good race as well.
Yep, it should be. And we will be broadcasting. We're going to try to broadcast every DBF race from now on, and hopefully David will be here next week. He wasn't able to make it today. He might not be here on Thursday either, so he might be there on the weekend. We're also going to cover the Cup Series racing that they do. Remember, the Nationwide Series and a Cup Series, they both have cautions, so it would be a much different environment and atmosphere in those races. And the Cup Series race is Saturday morning, so Wake up early in the morning, get your breakfast going, and come watch a race. Should be fun.
All right, thank you guys for coming out.
Yep, hope you all have a great night and see you on Thursday.